Let's talk about hair, baby. Let's talk about you and me. Let's talk about therapy and what to do before bleaching.
Okay, I get it. Somebody's probably dying right now, but this ambulance needs to hurry up. Okay, so today I want to talk about hair. Primarily going platinum blonde. This right here, this very light platinum, I have very dark hair. Look at my brows. Brows compared to hair, very dark, very different. So if you're considering going platinum blonde, these are 5 things that I wish I knew or listened to before I went through the entire process. I want to be clear that this is not an easy process, so if you're considering going platinum blonde, you have to be ready for it because it's a huge commitment, it's a lot of money, and it's a lot of maintenance. It's a process. So first thing I wish I would have known before going blonde is that it's a process and it's not gonna happen instantly. There were many, many, many hairstylists and colorists that like turned me down and would not, even though my hair is really short, they would not even entertain the idea of going platinum blonde, and I would send them photos. My main inspiration was seeing Kim Kardashian as that very white, icy platinum blonde. My hair, she thinks. It's a lot of hair extensions that she's wearing, and her hair is actually really, really short. Like, it probably takes me, on average, 5 to 6 hours every time I go in to get it bleached. And I get it bleached every about 6 weeks. And the darker your hair is, the much more challenging it's going to be to get it light. You have to watch a lot of Kardashians. I drink lots of champagne and take lots of Excedrin. And I kind of just have to wait up the process of bleaching, re-bleaching, and then toning. Bleaching is when you strip the color, and then toning is when you add in kind of like a purple hue to wash out the yellow tones so that it looks very light, icy, a little more white, a little more silver, and more platinum. Next thing I wish I would have known is that the quality of your hair, like just the texture and the color itself, but primarily the texture, changes drastically. Like, I was so used to having very thick, full hair, and I still have pretty thick, full hair. It really does thin it out, and your hair is like completely prone to breakage. Your hair's gonna break, like that's a reality. And you just have to really take care of it, make sure you're putting in good oils, make sure you're hydrating it, and make sure you're not washing it too often so that the hydration kind of comes back into it and you can revive your hair, which you can do, and I've done it. At the start, when I first went platinum, I used to do a lot of coconut oil, which I really recommended at first, but I don't recommend doing it as much as I did when I first started bleaching my hair because I realized that the coconut oil also lifts the toner and it strips all of it out, so it makes your hair yellowy. My last wash before getting the bleach is when I'll do coconut oil again, so that way, because at that point, the toner's already all faded out. Number 3, your scalp also changes. Because my hair is really dark, that it takes a lot more intensity and time that I have to sit with bleach on my head, but your scalp does burn. Currently, I have a lot of little scabs. Not everybody deals with scabbing, but again, because my hair was so dark and there's a lot more that goes into bleaching it, it does get a little scabby, primarily in the back where we have to bleach it the most because it's the most resistant to lifting the color. Usually it is done by like the 4th day after bleaching, the scabbing is done. It's not like bloody scabs, it's more of like a yellowy, gauzy type of dried scab that I guess is just your body, you know, trying to protect your scalp. I don't know. Talk to a dermatologist, talk to somebody that knows about skin more than me. It is gross, so if you don't like having a gross scalp for a couple of days, might not be for you. 4th thing is that your hair will be yellow at some point. You can see it right now, it doesn't look yellow, it looks very white, it looks very icy. It's taken us a year to actually perfect this. I now see Kelly Christine, who's based out of West Hollywood, love her, and she's been incredible, and we've kind of gone through this process together to perfect the color. Even the color that you see right now, this is not the color that it'll be next weekend or the weekend after that, because with time, as your hair, as you wash it, as the oils start to go through it, as you work out and sweat starts to go through it, or with product, like, the toner does get lifted, and your hair does change color. Week 5 or 6, people are like, oh, you went blonder, or you've decided to dye your hair, you know, more yellowy blonde. And that's not by choice, that's just as your hair, as the roots grow in, it also kind of creates a different contrast. Your hair does at some point get yellowy and blonde-y, and that's just kind of something I've had to accept. I don't love when it gets yellow, I don't love when it gets brassy, but that's when you bring in products like purple shampoo. That is something that you have to accept, is that at some point your hair does get a little yellowy. Usually in between bleaches, probably at like the 3 to 4 week mark, sometimes sooner or later, depending on if I have an event coming up or if I have an event that weekend, I'll go in and I'll have it toned. What Kelly will do is she'll put like a really dark, either like a violet or like a dark gray type of toner on my hair to give it more of an ashy look, so that it looks more of like a fade and not as hard of a line break in between the two different hair colors. Last thing that I wish I would have known is the amount of maintenance it takes to keep the integrity of your hair. You can't wash it every day, which if you are doing is not a great thing anyway, because it really dries out your hair and it really dries out your scalp. But I do like a deep wash probably once a week. Usually on like a Saturday or Sunday is when I'll do a deep wash, and I'll use the Olaplex shampoo, Olaplex conditioner, Olaplex number 3 treatment, and I'll do the purple shampoo, because you're supposed to do that about once a week. In between deep washes, I do dry shampoo. I really like either the Drybar dry shampoo, because that one, I love the way it smells, and I just kind of like the way that it lifts all of the oils. Or another really good one that I'm starting to use is the one by DP Hue. Drybar dry shampoo is a little more chalky, and the DP Hue shampoo isn't as chalky, like it doesn't make your hair as white. I kind of like the chalkier look sometimes. I usually like really brush it out, and I'll spray like some Moroccan oil to kind of keep the shine on the ends a little bit. I like the DP Hue one. It's not as strong, not as intense. It has more of an apple cider vinegar in it, so it kind of really focuses on maintaining the pH of your scalp, so it's a little healthier for your hair and your scalp. But I alternate. But in between dry shampoos and washes, sometimes if I really feel like my hair is gross, especially if I've like gone to the gym or something, what I'll do is I'll use the DP Hue apple cider vinegar rinse. You just drip it all over, kind of let it sit, rub your scalp with it. It has apple cider vinegar in it, so it resets the pH balance and also kind of lifts some of the dirt and the oils in it. And that one I feel like really cleans my hair without like stripping it of any of the oils, because it also has like argan oil in it too. I definitely don't wash it after bleaching it. I give it probably up to a week, just because it is so dry and sensitive. And again, you have the scabs that you really want to heal, and you want your scalp to produce the oils to kind of hydrate it again and let the scabs kind of fall off naturally. So those are 5 things that I wish I would have known before going platinum. Be sure to follow me at Just Plain Zach if you're not doing so already, which you really should, because I have lots of great hair selfies on there, and I usually will show the entire process when I go in to see Kelly Christine to get my hair bleached. It's not a fun process. She makes it fun, but it is a very long process. It can be a bit of a painful process. So any questions that you have about bleaching your hair, maintaining your hair health afterwards, please let me know. Happy to answer it. I'm always down to share hair hacks or any hacks. So let me know in a comment below, and don't forget to follow me and subscribe. Okay, thanks.